Dear viewers, and welcome to a new edition of Nile TV's Your Say. Your Say is a show dedicated to give way to your say on current events. Our show documents events, sheds light on the perspectives of international figures on them, and gives a regular person, wherever they are, a platform to speak their opinion. Today on Your Say, we'll be tackling the latest developments that took place here in Egypt. The presidency has issued a statement reiterating trust in the Minister of Defense, Abdel Fattah el-Sisi. The statement praised his distinguished nationalist role and renewed his appreciation of the armed forces' role in protecting the nation. The statement said the presidency is following up on media reports citing unknown sources, which it said contain false rumors concerning the military. It called on the media to seek accuracy in reporting news, especially news dealing with the national security. The military also announced it was following news attributed to unknown alleged military sources through social media about the resignation of the Minister of Defense, Abdel Fattah el-Sisi. The military said it did not issue any statements in this regard, stressing that it heeds the dangers of such rumors on the national security of the country. It said the official military spokesperson is the only source for statements regarding the army issues. President Mohamed Morsi held talks with a number of political figures last week. The meetings included talks with Dr. Ayman Noor, head of Ghad al-Thawra party. A statement by the presidency said the meeting discussed means of reaching national harmony and measures needed to achieve stability in the country. The meeting was attended by Presidential Assistant Dr. Pakine Misharawi and Presidential Counselor Dr. Ayman Ali, who is also a member of the National Dialogue. It came in line with the presidency meetings with political figures to review the political situation in Egypt. Last week, the Freedom and Justice Party revealed the details of a meeting between head of the party, Dr. Mohammed Saad El-Katatni, and representative from the National Salvation Front. The NSF representatives attended the meeting, where head of the Dostur Constitution Party, Dr. Mohammed El-Baradai, and head of El-Wafd Party, Dr. Sayed El-Badawi. A statement by the National Justice and Freedom Party said they exchange views point about forming a government before the parliamentary elections. The statement said El-Katatni expressed the party's stance that the current situation makes it hard to reshuffle the cabinet ahead of the upcoming parliamentary elections. El-Katatni stressed the importance of putting all issues, including the government formation, on the table at the national dialogue with the presidency. He also said that the party insists on providing all legislative, procedural, and monitoring guarantees for transparency of the election. The statement by the head of the Freedom and Justice Party said that all parties have agreed to continue consultations and keep dialogue channels open for the sake of the national and the people's sake. Head of Al-Ghad Thawra party, Dr. Ayman Noor, rejected reports last week that the presidency had asked him to form a new government. Dr. Noor held talks with Mr. Amr Musa, head of the Mu'tamar, or the conference party, who is also a member of the National Salvation Front, last week. The meeting comes as part of attempts to overcome differences between the NSF and the presidency in order to reach a comprehensive national dialogue. President Mohamed Morsi received families of the missing security personnel in Sinai last week. The security personnel went missing on January 28, 2011, the fourth day of the revolution, named Friday of Wrath. The presidency said it following up on security investigations over the fate of the missing personnel. The presidency also said that the council had been assigned to be a constant contact with the families of the missing to update them on the developments with regard to the case. The cabinet has referred two laws to the Shura Council, Egypt's upper house of parliament, for endorsement. One of the laws deals with the right to hold public peaceful demonstrations, and the other is over witnesses protection. Cabinet spokesperson Ambassador Ala El-Hadidi said the council will also discuss an extension of draft law to amend articles in the penalties law and criminal act law dealing with the fighting terrorism. El-Hadidi said the step aims to execute one of the demands of the revolution, namely human pride. Minister of Irrigation and Water Resources Mohammed Bahaeddin was in Nigerian capital Abuja last week to attend meetings of the Council of the African Water Ministers headed by Egypt. Bahaeddin attended the meeting on behalf of Prime Minister Dr. Hisham Kandil. He said that they discussed means of financing clean water projects and new mechanism to provide for the sewage projects in the African continent. One person was killed and another was wounded when an apartment building collapsed in the Mediterranean city of Alexandria last week. The civil protection troops managed to recover one body and five injured people from under the rubble at the site of the collapsed building in Muharram Beg area.